Can artificial intelligence replace human creativity in writing and art? Can artificial intelligence think just like a human and produce human-like output? The new large language model generative AIs such as Bard from Google and ChatGPT from OpenAI are quite impressive and can do many things that seem human-like. But they're not quite up to the task. Let's see how they do writing a script for a sitcom. I'm going to ask Bard and ChatGPT to write a script for a sitcom set in Denver about a family with a dog. Neighbors are constantly bothering the family each episode, but each situation is funny. So we'll see how they do. Once we submit our prompt to ChatGPT and Google Bard, they get about writing a new script for our sitcom. As you can see, ChatGPT is really going to town typing this out. Bard takes a different approach. It just spits everything out all at once. But what's really nice about Bard is that it gives you three versions. So right up here, I have view other drafts. So I can look at three different drafts of this sitcom. As you can see, it's already formatted it with a scene. And then it comes down to scene two. And then down to scene three, scene four, scene five. And if we look at the first one from Bard, as you can see, it even has explanations down at the bottom. So it talks about different ways that the sitcom can expand, about what the next challenge may be. So it's very, very complicated and very nice. But as you can see, it leaves a lot to be wanted in the actual dialogue. There probably needs to be a bit more description. Let's see how ChatGPT did. ChatGPT has some camera cues and different formatting. Even tells whether or not the characters are excited or laughing or grinning. But also there are some details that are missing. But what's nice about these large language models is we can go ahead and ask it to rewrite it and add more detail. So let's try that. We're going to ask ChatGPT and Google Bard to rewrite the script with more dialogue and detailed descriptions of the sets. Describe the cameras and lighting. So let's see what happens. So it's now rewriting the script and giving us descriptions, hopefully, of the sets and what's going. So here you can see that it talks about the camera panning to show where the characters are sitting. Here on Google Bard, it's taken a different approach. So it describes everything in scene one, then breaks out the dialogue. And as you can see here, the dialogue is a lot lacking. So then it gets into scene two and has the dialogue, but the dialogue is kind of lacking here. So I would say that those that are employed writing scripts are still pretty safe with Google Bard. It just isn't up to the challenge yet. And to be honest, ChatGPT is not up to the challenge yet either, but it is getting a little bit better at having everything appear to work. Let's go one more time and rewrite the script again to see the power of interrogating the AI. It's better to ask it to try new things and force it to think. Otherwise, you'll just get generic garbage out from Bard and ChatGPT. So we're going to ask it to rewrite the script with a new idea that has not been on TV and add more details. Anytime you can have the AI try to imagine something, it's going to do a bit better. So we'll go ahead and see how this goes. So here we now have a title for our script in ChatGPT, and it's going along and describing everything we're going to have in our TV script. And the same thing has now happened over here on our script from Google. The same thing has happened over on the left with our script from Bard. And remember that we get three scripts from Bard. With ChatGPT, we just get one script, although ChatGPT is generally more thorough. So look at this. The family steps onto the back porch and the camera captures their surprise as they discover their enthusiastic gardening neighbor, Mr. Garcia, tending to his vegetable patch. However, his beloved pet chickens have escaped and are clucking around the backyard. So we'll have to see what happens with all these chickens over here. And on Google Bard, we have Sparky and just not a lot of dialogue. So AI is going to become much more prevalent in the creative process and especially in text generation. But right now for developing an entire script from scratch, it's just not up to the task. AI generative tools always do a lot better if you give it a nice detailed prompt. So for example, if I take this prompt from ChatGPT and I put it into Bard and I say write a script about and paste in the description from ChatGPT, it's going to do a lot better because now it has details to actually start to build something on and work with the statistical large language model. So Google Bard will hopefully do a little bit better. But as you can see, it does create text, but it just is not up to the task. Let's see what the same thing happens if we do that with ChatGPT. So we're going to go ahead and copy this from Bard. And then on ChatGPT, we'll go ahead and send it a message and tell it just to write a script about this prompt and see what happens. So now it's really just writing about the chickens, and it still has much better information and dialogue than Google Bard. So in this case, ChatGPT is really getting a lot closer to replacing writers with artificial intelligence. But I think it's safe to say that these tools are not up to the task yet. But in 5 years, I think they'll be more than ready for the task. So right now, all of us humans really need to start to negotiate how we're going to spend time with these AIs and how we're going to either regulate artificial intelligence or figure out how people are compensated for creative work. Because remember, all these large language models were built on creative works that artists and writers already made. And they're not being compensated for these tools. So there needs to be new models for how creative work is done, compensated, and used. But for right now, AI and artificial intelligence cannot replace writers.